What's up, guys? Back with another video, and today I have a review, and I'm gonna show you how to set it up. The Stealth Cam, it's the QS12X, and I haven't seen a review on this camera. I've seen it on like the, I don't know if it's the QS12 like S or C or something like that, but I haven't seen one on the X, so we're gonna do that. So I've already opened the box, just so it'd be easier in the video. And I've taken out all like the other stuff, just the box here, so you don't need that. This is the camera. And I'm gonna be switching like the view around so you can see like what I'm seeing, and you can set it up along with me if you buy it or, you know, just wanna see it. So I'll show you all what comes in the box first, and then we'll get to the actual setup. So the first thing is just a little stealth cam, kinda like showing like their other products. So like you can see, they got the 12-volt battery and the little handheld thing to go check your memory cards. I've actually been thinking about getting the 12-volt battery because I have another trail cam my cousins let me use if I can fix it. It's the it's a Covert trail cam, and it's like a pretty nice one, but it doesn't have the battery pack in it. But it's got a like a 12 or a 6-volt hookup down here, so I can do that. So maybe it'll work. I might do a video on that too. But yeah, so that's it. Next thing, I've got the, you know, the instruction manual, and I'm gonna be showing you guys all the stuff. So you don't really, I mean, yes, you probably look at it, but you know. Yeah, that's about it. Comes with a, oh yeah, this is probably important. It comes with your strap hang on the tree. Comes with a pretty sweet sticker, you know, stick on your cooler, you know, whatever. Back your truck, I don't know. Do whatever you want. Cheers. Yeah, that's pretty much all the crap that comes in the box. So, another thing. Gonna need a memory card. And I can't, where did that go? I bought this at Academy, or not the memory card, but I bought the camera at Academy. And it was around 60, I think. Let's look at the receipt here. Yeah, 60. And in the store, they have like memory cards next to it. The biggest memory card this thing can take is a 32 gig. And the one they had there, it's like the Stealth Cam brand. It's like, it was $32 for 32 gig. And that's kind of crazy. Now, maybe, if I don't know what the difference is, and I don't really care, because I'm not paying $32 for a memory card. I just went to Best Buy and got the SanDisk Ultra Plus, the 32 gig, $12. So, you know, steal. Yeah, I'm gonna flip around the camera, and then we're gonna get into it, setting it up and everything, and like setting the date and time and, you know, camera settings and whatnot. So yeah, let's get to it.
All right, so here we have our camera. As you can see it a little more close up. It's got some cool bark design on here. So first thing we're gonna do is take off or open up the compartment with this little latch. You just pull it up and open it up, and here's your screen and the buttons and your on off button where you put everything. So first thing we're gonna do is put in the batteries. And I don't know why this confused me so much, but it just shows the plus and minus, and all of them. So pretty much if it says plus, you put the plus facing up both, and I didn't know that. And then on this one, you put, you know, your minus facing up. All right, so you can close that in. You just pull a little lever here and lock it in. Oh, there it goes. Next, what we're going to do is put in the memory card. So this is the memory card. Just so your standard memory card. The biggest this can take is 32 gig. I think I already said that, but... and then you forgot to say that you put the chips facing up. and you just push it in until you hear it click, and then you're good. So next we're doing going to do is turn the camera on. Pull it on, and I'll do that. All right, so next what we're going to do, shuttle, it has three settings. It has quick set one, quick set two, and then custom. What you're going to want to do is go to custom and click enter, and that should come up with your date. If not, you can use this arrow to find the date. So there it shows your date again. And to change it, we're going to click enter. And you do your month first. January, February, March, April, May, June, July. You're going to click enter. The date. Crap, what day is it? All right, so we're going to turn it on. And it has three settings. So this is the up button to change back between the settings, or you can use the down button. But it's got quick set one, quick set two, and custom. And what it's set on, and I'm going to keep it set on, is quick set one is photos, quick set two is video, and then custom. So I'll show you how to do that later. First, you're going to go to custom and hit enter, and we're going to set the date. So if you don't see a date here, you can just use the up arrow or the up button, whichever you want, and keep changing it until it shows the date. So that shows the date. So to set the date, you click enter. So it is July right now. So we're going to go January, February, March, April, May, June, July. So 7. Click enter to go to the date. It's the 29th. So we're going to go to all the way to 29. The up button. Click enter. And obviously 2019. Then click enter. And there you have your date set. So next we're going to go to the time. And right now it's set at 10:22 p.m. And right now it's 2:24. So we're going to click enter. Use your up arrow to go to your desired number, whatever your time is when you're doing this. So 2, enter, and then switch it to the a minute, and then with this you can just switch between PM and AM. We'll go ahead and click enter, and now we have our time set. You can see our different settings here. We're gonna go first to the quick set one, and you let it go down or count down. This is pretty much if gives you time to get away from your camera so it doesn't take a picture of you. But as you see, it'll say ready, and now it is going. So it just took another picture of me. And it'll wait 30 seconds when it's sitting in the tree after it takes a picture of something to take another picture. So it's just not constantly taking pictures of the same thing. But I'll show you, it'll count down, and then I can move something over in front of the camera and it'll go off. See, it just took another picture. So we're going to stop using that because I'm done taking pictures. All right, so I'm going to show you. It's the same thing with the video, but I'm going to show you this anyways. So you got to wait for the video delay. Actually, I'm not going to do that because I don't want it to take a video. But it's the same thing with that you did with the photos. You just wait for it, and then when it says ready, then it is set. So if you want to make your own custom settings, which I don't know why you need to, but if you want to, you can just click the enter button. We're already set the time and the date, And if you want it on video, you can change the video length here. You just click enter and then you can change the video length. So if I wanted to make the video length 15 seconds, then I could do that and I just click enter. I could have a 5 second delay between each video, or let's see how much you can do, or a 120 second delay or 60 second. So I'm just going to do like a 30 second delay like the pictures. And if you want the custom site to be video, you do that. And if you want to change it to a photo, you can click enter and then go up and change it to the photo. And then that's how you can change your settings. So you can do the burst and everything you change, you just have to click enter to change and then enter when you're done. And like you can have the 30 second or 15 second, 10 second, 5 second, 120 second, whatever you want. I'm just going to set it on 15. And all right, so this is your resolution and you can change it to whatever you want. And once you're done with all that, you just go to quit, and then you have your setting, and you wait for the video delay, and then you're ready to go. So that's pretty much it with this camera. It's really simple. I haven't used it, or I haven't like actually used it yet, so I don't know what kind of quality of pictures it takes. I can show you how to set up the strap real quick. So what you do pretty much is just have the back of your camera, make sure the buckle is facing down, and then put your straps or your strap through, put it around your tree, and then when you get to the other side, you just want to put it through right here, and then put it up, and through, here you can put it like this, or you put it through right here, like I just did, tighten it up, and then you put it back through the second slot, and that pretty much locks it in. So, yeah, that's pretty much it with this camera. I hope you guys liked it. Subscribe if you want to see some more stuff. I'm going to be doing some hunting videos this bow season. If you have any questions about this camera, just comment and I'll try to answer them as soon as possible. So yeah, see you guys later.